Welcome to another edition of the Lodge's Cockpit, where we give you a bird's eye view of what the men and women of Lodge's Field have been up to. My name is Ricky Baptista, and I'm the Chief of Public Affairs for the 65th Air Base Group. Today's flight is a special one. Today, we're going international. So buckle up. And get ready for takeoff. As many of you know, the 65th Air Base Group is a tenant unit on a Portuguese Air Force base designated as Air Base Number 4. On Air Base 4, there are two command structures, Air Base 4 and the headquarters Azores Air Zone, also known as HAZ. In the cockpit today, we have the commander, Azores Air Zone, Brigadier General João Pereira. General Pereira, thank you for joining us in the cockpit today.
Thank you.
Can you tell us a little bit about yourself? What type of things you've done in the Portuguese Air Force and what your specialty is?
Okay, I started the Air Force at 18 with the Academy, and basically I did all the pilot training in the US, by the way, in Mississippi, Columbus, Mississippi. And that's from there, I just flew many different airplanes in the Air Force, the 38, A7, Epsilon, F-16, and then afterwards in international environment, AWACS, NATO AWACS, the E3. But basically the core part, let's say, most of this time I flew F-16, so it's my main airplane, which I flew for about 15 years in a row, from young lieutenant up to colonel. So was really my jet, let's say, and I love it.
Were you able to fly across the globe? Did you fly in different air zones?
Yes.
Kind of what can you talk about in terms of where have you flown?
Okay, I had the chance to be a change pilot in Belgium Air Force, flying F-16 with them, which was pretty good. So I saw different areas, let's say more in the north area of Europe, flew across most of the states there. Had the chance to go also to cross the Atlantic to Canada and fly there in Maple Flag, a very nice exercise, almost the same as Red Flag in the US, which I did in the Portuguese Air Force, by the way. And a lot of missions close to the eastern border in the Lithuania, also for the Baltic air policing. And I've been in many, many countries around, I think in Europe, most of them. And Afghanistan in the AWACS twice, two commissions there. When I was there, it was AWACS doing support for control. And I was able to go there for twice for Mazar al-Sharif, which was a very different experience from what I had in the past. So it was also very good for me in the career. So I had a chance to travel a lot in the Air Force, and which I love it, and know more places and work with different people in the international environment, which is always very interesting you learn a lot about it.
Educational.
Yeah, educational, that's the word.
That's wonderful. I mean, you are a gentleman of the air.
Yes, I am.
That's wonderful. So as your current responsibilities as the commander of the Azores Air Zone, I assume you probably don't have as much time to fly right now as you used to.
Correct. Flying part is almost done, let's say. Unfortunately, I love to fly still, and it's something that is in your ADN. So basically it gets in your body and never leaves. So you always love to fly, of course. But here, it's not my job. So I have to let the others do the job flying wise, and I have to do the things in the ground that allow them to do the job in the mission. I had a chance to fly once in a while. Just I feel like a kid back in the cockpit, you know, feel very young and healthy doing that. But just for fun, for a few times, and that's it. The rest will be in my office behind the computer and try to solve problems.
Flying a desk, as a lot of us do in the Air Force. General, can you tell us a little bit about your responsibilities as the Azores Air Command commander, and kind of what the Azores Air Zone is responsible for?
Yes. Azure basically has three pillars as a mission. Basically, as to control all the activity in the region, in the Azure's autonomy region. And basically, we have two assets only now, but we can be assigned with more assets in case we need it. So basically, we have the C295 transport airplane, and we have the helicopter, two helicopters, Merlin EH-101. And basically, we can have assigned additional means in case we need it. And we are responsible for all the activity within the Nine Islands area. Besides that, the second pillar is the cooperation with international allies. And the main focus is the United States Air Force, of course, here stated as the 65, and all the players that pass by, and different countries, different allies that use the base as support platform, logistic platform to go in and out from different countries and places across the Atlantic. And the third pillar, and very important and maybe the most visible one, is the support of the civilian population throughout the civilian authorities. So basically, every day almost we do evacuations in between the islands, the Nine Islands. Right now, this year, as we speak, we are doing 1.33 evacuations, persons evacuated in between the islands for medical evacuations. Besides the evacuations from the ships that cross our Atlantic. And so it's a lot. So last year we just got the record so far in the past years with over 600 hours of mission, over 300 missions itself, and over 400 people rescued. So it's a lot. So, and this is the most visible part, because it happens almost every day, sometimes two, three times a day, during the daytime or night, and it's something that people feel like we are really helping them.
Absolutely.
So it's more visible.
It directly touches people's lives when they see the helicopter, if they're on an island. For those that know the Azores, not all the islands have hospital capability,
yes.
So you need to transfer them. So when they see you, you are kind of the guardians of the angel, or angel of angels for them, to be able to transport them to the areas that they need to get to.
Correct. And this is a very small community, as you can see. So everybody knows a cousin, uncle, somebody that already was saved, let's say, by the Air Force. So it's very unique, because it's a very small community. Some islands have less than 1,000 people, as you know. So everybody knows everybody.
And your international experience helps because of the international waters, or the flights that come through here. They're not only Portuguese or US flights. They're gonna be third nation countries flying by. And so we support them, or the flight line supports them. And the Azores Air Zone mission is definitely important for anybody flying over or sailing through the Atlantic Ocean.
Yes, and besides that, I should have added even a four pillar. Let me go back a little bit. The three pillars are basically the military mission, as I said. But we even have a fourth one that we can add, which is civilian airport. Let's call it that way. So the base, it works as well as a civilian airport, and is certified as from 2018. So and there's a lot of activity from the civilian companies, especially Ryanair when they started, but also all the national companies and international companies. And we have about 15,000 movements per year, which is a lot for airbase. Let's say for airbase in the Portuguese Air Force is a lot, and a lot of them are from the civilian part. So we also give all that support for emergencies, for air traffic control, for fire crews that are US in this case. And all this support is provided by the base to the civilians. They could not have an airport like this in other places. This is the best runway we have in the Azores, by the way.
Yes, that's wonderful news. And this kind of goes into my next question here, is how would you evaluate the importance of Lodge's airbase, or Lodge's field, or airbase number 4, to the overall Portuguese defense strategy and to international security?
Okay. There are also two areas of interest, let's say. One is the military part itself, as you said. All the ocean around us, it's huge part of the ocean that we have responsibility, not only for search and rescue, but also for the international waters and international waters around, which is the economic zone that we have around. And we have to manage to know what is happening on those waters, okay? So we need to have means to be able to see what others are doing in our waters, let's say, in the more close area to the islands, which is still a lot because they are 9 different islands with the area around it, plus the economic zone, which is even larger. And then we have also the area of responsibility for search and rescue, which is even larger. And has a lot of deep frontiers with 8 countries and 3 continents, which is impressive. So we are very small mainland, but with a large area in the sea of responsibility, which is one of the largest in the world. So as national defense, we have this responsibility, but also in the civilian part for all the goods that are underneath the surface, let's say, and they need to preserve for now and for the future, for the environment, for example, we have responsibilities. And this is also delegated in the Air Force to manage this area in the air, but also to look what is in the surface, let's say, together with, of course, the Navy for the remaining part.
So there's a lot of moving parts to this, and understanding that the overall area is quite large. You know, you talk about 3 continents, 8 different countries. And for some people, they didn't realize that, they didn't know that. That's very good information to have and be able to put out there. One of my last questions for you, General, is you touched on it a little bit in terms of the international platform. Here at Air Base 4 at Lodges Field, there's the 65th Air Base Group, the U.S. contingency, U.S. military contingency. What's it like working with the U.S. Air Force?
It's great. I'll put it in the word like that. The relation has been very good since so many years. I've been here for over decades, since 43, and coming here in 45 from Santa Maria. So it's a very long relationship, which has been endured and enhanced, let's say, with the time. Even though there are changes, because world is changing, and of course in the past there were more people stationed here in Lodges in the beginning, but now with the new technology, the new airplanes, with the air refueling capabilities, all that, we have less people, the US part. We have less people, the Portuguese Air Force part, with the shrinking of the armed forces, but still the cooperation is great and the importance is not less. That's what I see. So strategically, the importance stays the same, even maybe higher, because times are very difficult in the world. Let's say conflicts are not less, definitely not less. There are wars and conflicts all over the place and different ones. And this is still a very strategic place for US, for us, and even international allies. But the numbers are reduced, cooperation is strength. So it's very strong, and we're going to keep it that way, I'm sure, for the future, because it needs to be that way. We need to be a team, because we all have the same mission and we all go for the same goals. We understand each other, so which is good.
That's wonderful, knowing that Portugal and the U.S. are some of the longest standing allies. Yes. That are out there. And so the U.S. presence here at Lodges Field spans over 70 years. And it's wonderful to hear that the cooperation is as strong as ever.
Oh, yes. Yes.
General, do you have anything else that you would like to share with our folks?
I would like to say that it's a pleasure to be here in your cockpit, a very nice place.
It's not an F-16 cockpit, but it's...
almost.
It's almost.
I saw that picture already from the F-16 landing here. And it's a pleasure for me to be here. And I think it's very important to keep these ties close with the U.S. part and talk and share experiences in between us. Because it's all about cooperation. Nobody can do anything alone. So we need to work together, and that's what we're doing. And this is also helps to be more close, and friendship and partnership, all that together to make it better and do a better our mission, which is what we are doing here.
Well, thank you for joining us in the cockpit today again, General. Thank you. Well, that's our flight for today. We're getting ready to land.
Hope you enjoyed it, and we look forward for our next flight.